Hello guys, in today's tutorial I'll be making our player our cat player to shoot balls of fur. So for instance, if it's in our normal player, then it shouldn't shoot fur balls because you know it's a person. But if it turns into a cat and it's in the cat state, if I press a key, for example the J key, then it should throw balls of fur, and those balls of fur could, for example, kill an enemy or destroy walls or something like that. First off, let me import the balls of fur thing. So this is the ball of fur. So fur ball, put it into Unity, into the sprites, and we want to make it a point, true color, and the size. Let me check because it I put him it's a bit big right now. Apply. Okay, it must be a bit bigger. So let's see, maybe 50. Apply. Check. Still you can see it. Can you? Oh, you can. It's actually okay, this is a good size. Okay. So it will be at 50. Anyways, what we want to do is to instantiate this at a certain speed whenever the player is in the cat state. And it presses the J key. So let's go into the evolution script, which we made in the last tutorial. And here in the update function, we're going to check if the player's lives are equal to 2 or greater than. So just copy this part over here. If the player's lives are greater or equal to 2, and the player is pressing the J key, and we can also put and the player is pressing the J key, input.get key. J key, key code J, dot J, and we'll be also putting a timer, so and can shoot, then it will shoot balls of fur. So let's put here that instantiation thing, so instantiate. So what we want to instantiate is a game object, so type here game object fur ball equals, and let's make it as a game object. It instantiates, and you have to put this here because it usually instantiation is an instantiation of an object, as you can see in here, but we want it to be a game object. So instantiate, and what we want to instantiate is a projectile with a certain position, which will be the cat mouth dot position, and at a certain rotation should be quaternion, and we can make it dot identity. If you want, you can put here like a random value, but this works fine like that. So now let's put these variables on the top. So bool can shoot public game object projectile tile and public transform catmouth. Okay, one last thing that we want to do is to give the velocity to this, and we can do it by typing here furball dot rigidbody2d dot velocity equals a new vector 2. And we can make that vector be 0 in the y and something in the x. This can be a public variable. So just type here velocity, and let's make here public float velocity. Save. Okay, so now let's make that projectile thing in that cat mouse position. So in Unity, let's change the player into a cat temporarily. So just click on here and change the player to wild to be a kitten, so that we can create a new game object. So Control Shift N to create a new game object like that, and we want to make it the child of the player, which is the lives player, and you can even name it cat mouth like that. and place it near the cat's mouth, like there. There you go. Okay, that's done. Now I want to create that projectile, and that projectile will just be that furball that you created, so it's in here. Put the furball over here, and let's give it a collider. It will actually be a trigger, so you can make it a box, I guess. It's kind of boxy. Like so. And let's make it a trigger. And let's put this furball into the prefabs folder and delete it from the scene, like this. And now let's go into the lives player, scroll down into the evolution script, which was the one that we're changing. Change the velocity to something positive, like 5. And change the put the cat's mouth to be this point over here, and make the projectile be the furball in the prefabs. Okay. Now we've got some stuff done. And there's something that I forgot, which was, for example, if our player was moving to the right, wanted that projectile to move to the right, but if our player was moving to the left, then the player should be shot to the left. So that will be done by multiplying the velocity times the game object dot transform dot local scale dot x, because if you don't know, if the player is standing to the right, then the local scale is 1 of the x is 1, and then if he's standing to the left, then the local scale of the x is minus 1. Anyways, that's done. Now all I have to do is to make the timer. So the way that this is done is that first, whenever our player shoots, then the can shoot equals false, because he just shot, he can shot again. And let's create here a variable, a timer. So if can shot equals false, if can shot equals false, then we want the timer to start. So let's create here a timer variable and the start of the timer variable, so that those will be two floats. One will be a public float time, and the other will be a float called timer, and the time can be by default one float, like this, so that we can shoot every 1 second. Anyways, if the player can't shoot, then the timer starts. So timer minus equals, so the timer initially is 1, it isn't, but we'll set it as 1, equals time dot delta time. So this way, for each frame that it passes, the timer is decreased for the amount of time of that frame, this, which is just like normal counting. And now you can put here, if the timer is less than 0, then we want the can shoot variable to be equal to true again. So can shoot equals true. And we can actually put it here less than or equal to make it more precise. And the timer equals time, like this. And hopefully this should be working fine. Let me see. Okay, so if I go into Unity, oh, by the way, let's change the default sprite to be idle, because we don't want to always see a kitten. I mean, it's cute, but you know, person is better. Anyways, here it is. And if I press the J key right now, I can do stuff. So if I catch a flower, I'm a cat right now. And if I press the J key, I can shoot stuff, but for some reason something is happening. Let's see. Oh, right, that's right. There's no rigid body in the furball. So let's just add a rigid body to the furball. So click on the prefab that you just created off a furball, add a component, physics 2D, rigid body 2D, make fixed angle true, and make ease kinematic true, so that it isn't affected by any forces. Play, and right now you'll see that it works fine. We are cats, and you can see that it shoots some stuff. every 1 second, which is fun. Now what we want to do is to make this projectile actually do something good. So what I want to do is to make this projectile be able to delete terrain. So I'm going to copy a bit of terrain over here and paste it on top of the player of the map over there, like that. And what we're going to do is so that, and we're going to do a script on the furball that will enable the furball to, when it hits this thing over here, then it will delete it. So let's go into the furball, add a component, new script, furball script, create an add. We have just opened the script, and basically the remember the furball is a trigger, so we want to make a void on trigger enter 2D, enter 2D with the collider 2D parameter, other, like so, and the other is basically whatever the this is colliding with. So we're going to make here a chain of if clauses, a small chain, if other dot game object dot tag, so whatever the furball is colliding with equals terrain, and right now the terrain hasn't a tag yet, I'm going to give it in an instant, equals terrain. Then we want to destroy other dot game object, and we want to also destroy this dot game object like that. Else if it isn't a terrain, and if it isn't also the player, so if other dot game object dot tag isn't the player, we want also the furball to disappear, because if I didn't put this if clause right here, then as soon as the furball came off of the cat's mouth, it will be deleted, and we don't want that. We want it only to be deleted when it's something that's not the cat. So save this. Okay, and with this done, all we have to do is to give the terrain tag to this terrain over here. So tag it, add a tag, give it the terrain tag, like that. So click tag terrain, and let's apply it so that it can be applied to all of these mounds of dirt over here. And you know, just let's add one more thing just to top it off, which is a sound, and that sound will be the sound of a meow. So I have here a meow sound. Let me just play it for you. As you can see, meow. Anyways, there's a very easy way to play this sound right now. So just go into the prefabs, into the furball, and what we want to do is to drag the that sound, so meow, into the furball, and it will play on awake, and on awake is whenever the furball isn't instantiated, meaning when it's launched. So basically every time that our player throws a furball, it will meow. So let's play. As you can see, those blocks are being deleted, and the cat meows. The sound isn't very high, let me try to change that. There you go, now it's higher. Save. As you can see, if I press J, you hear the meow. And there you go. One last thing that I'm going to do is to make the furball also disappear by time, because we don't want the furball to navigate in space forever. So that script has already been made. So just go into the prefabs, furball, and let's add a script to it. Script, destroy time, and the destroy time can be like 20 seconds. And you know that you can trade this script. This is the script over here. When it starts, it calls a destroy thing, and it destroys this game out after some time. And there you go. That's today's tutorial. Thank you for watching. See you in the next time.